We're going to make this graphic into a website. I made already sections of what the website's going to be. These are going to be the divs. There's going to be the header. There's going to be navigation. There's going to be the banner. There's going to be a spacer one, article, section, footer, spacer two. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 divs that we're going to have. Bear with me because there's a lot of stuff that we're going to go over. You'll notice that I made little red squares here for each div. In HTML5, we're going to be doing header, nav, banner. These are not classes, dot header. It's just going to be header because HTML5 has a new way of doing things. And they took the words like header and navigation and made them HTML, so we don't have to put them in the CSS as classes, but we do have to call them in the CSS as a tag, not a class. Okay? So the first thing I want you guys to realize is there's only, even though we made this an image for our client, to show the client what the website's gonna look like, it's also a map for us to make our website. But we're not going to use a lot of it for graphics in our website. The only piece we're going to use for our website when we cut it up is going to be the logo, the Facebook little logo, the banner image, and these two things down here, the green circles and the blue little buttons here. And we actually can make that in CSS too, but we'll just make them images. It'll be easier. Okay. So, inside of this div, we're going to do 1, 2, 3, 4 divs. I should have put that in there, but you'll see what we do. We're going to put 2 divs in here, and then we're going to put 2 divs in here, and a navigation. We're going to put 2 divs in here, one for the logo, one for the Facebook, and the text. This is going to be all text in here. Everything that you see is text is going to be text, like home services, navigation. The blue background is going to be blue. It's not going to be an image. The spacer one here is going to be blue. It's not going to be an image. The green behind here is going to be a color, not an image. The green behind here is going to be a color, not an image. And the footer is going to be a color, not an image. So now that we've gotten that taken care of, let's start putting it together inside of HTML. In our notepad, we're going to do file save as. Of course, let's go to our desktop. And let's open up the Ohio Dental folder, and I'm going to call this index.html and click save. And if we go to my Ohio Dental folder and you open it up, you'll see that I have some assets in here, some images, index.html, and the index.psd that we're just looking at in Photoshop. We've got the logo.png, we've got the banner image, we've got the image of the doctor, and then the dental sketch that I had too. So what I want to do is I want to organize these up a little bit. I want to do a new folder, and I'm going to call this one images, and I'm going to put all the images in this folder that are going to be associated with the website. Then I'm going to make a new folder called images site or images original. These are all the images you use to make the website. This could be the sketch. This could be the index.psd. Then we need to make another folder called CSS because we're going to put the style sheet in there. So while I'm doing that, let's take this one and do file save as style sheet.css and put it inside the CSS folder. Save that. Let's close the style sheet for now. Let's start working on the index.html page. You'll see that the style sheet is in here inside the CSS folder. Let's open that up with Notepad. And let's start writing the code. The HTML shell, HTML, and then close the HTML. And then we want to do our title tag. And this is going to be for the I'm all over the place. Title, and we're gonna name this one Ohio family dentist. For search engine optimization, Ohio is the state. Family dentist is what we're looking for. So if someone writes that in, that's what they're going to get. Then we're going to put in the body tag, not the knobby, but the body tag. And then we're going to put in, oops, I forgot to put the head. Got to put the head in for all of your CSS and JavaScript information. Okay, we're going to make this HTML compliant. So what I need to do is start working on that. So what we could do is an exclamation point and write the word doc type in uppercase letters. Then we need to do, in after the title, we need to do a meta tag. Meta char set equals quotation marks UTF dash 8, and that has to be in uppercase letters, UTF dash 8. Usually HTML can be all spelled in lowercase. I like doing that because it's easier to spell things. And then we're going to put the link in for the HTML, for the CSS. The relative is the style sheet. Make sure you spell everything correctly. If you don't, then it won't work. You know that already. And then we're going to put style sheet.css. Going to make sure I'm writing things. I'm just not looking to make sure they're all spelled right. So let's look, go through it again. Title, meta, char, set, UTF-8, link, relative, style sheet, h reference equals style sheet.css. This is linked to, hello, move that, the CSS style sheet. So you could always say rename, copy this, put that right here, paste it. That's a common thing that I do. Now it's inside the CSS folder. So we have to put that here too, CSS forward slash. So it's coming from here into the folder, into the style sheet. Okay, so let's save that, Control S to save. Our next thing is, let's go back to the PSD that I showed you. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 divs, header, nav. So let's do this. We have the header first, and then close the header. Then we have the navigation next. Close the navigation. So I could take this, copy, paste, 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 paste. After the nav is the banner, and then where it says nav, right, banner. Then after the banner, let's see, we got banner, nav, spacer one, article. Oops. Where am I going? Spacer one. Spacer one. Then we have article. So hard to spell that word. And then after article, we have section, footer, spacer. Section, footer, and then I'll snag the spacer, put it here, and then I'll put the one as a two. Make sure you have a one and a spacer one, spacer one, spacer two, spacer two. All right, so we have those ready to go. Let's save that. Now, here's the deal. When working on this, you have your background. You have the white here, you have blue here, then you have white here, then you have like a light green, a blue, and the green on the bottom. So do we just use like a strip of this to use as the background color? Think about it. Will these text and the text here push the green down here so that it doesn't match going across. So what I usually do is, this is for desktop, I'm not even thinking about mobile right now, is I have a div that goes all the way across, all the way across, all the way across, all the way across. So we can do that one of two or three different, there's all these different kinds of ways to do it. So my header, let's just start there. We want a white header. We want it to be high enough, wide enough. We also want to have divs inside of it. So let's bring that down. Let's just work on the header first. First, the header. Let's open up our CSS so we can work on that too. Let's open that with Notepad. So now I have both open. All right, header doesn't need a dot in front of it because it doesn't need it to be a class. We want this to be, it's 9080 pixels wide, right? Let me see here if I were to, I think I made this 980 pixels wide, right? Let's see what happens. That's right, let's go back in time. There we go. Image size, 980. Okay, let's go back to our Notepad style sheet. We're gonna say width, colon, 980 pixels, semicolon. We're gonna put this on its own line. Put that on its own line. Then we're gonna write, we don't need to put the height in because the logo that we're gonna do is gonna be high enough for it. So, but we do want to center it. So, I always forget, you know, do so much. CSS, center div, W3C schools, yes. How do I do it? Look at that. We got our margin. Oh, it's margin, that's right. I always forget, man. My brain is very forgetful. So let's put margin. We want zero pixels on the top and bottom, and we want auto on the left and right. Auto means center, right? So let's save that, Control S. And then let's do a background color so we know what we're working with. Background dash color. And let's go with a red for now, just so we can see it. Okay, save that. Now let's open our index page in Chrome. Open with Google Chrome. All right, I'm not seeing anything in there yet. Let's put an image in there. Let's go back to HTML. Inside the header, we're gonna do one called logo or div class. I'm doing this all on the fly, guys. So we're gonna make mistakes, which is good because you'll see how I overcome them and troubleshoot them. Close the div. Inside this div, I'm going to put a image source equals, go to my images folder, /logo.png. All right, so that should be in there. Save that. Let's open up our page again and refresh it. See, oh yeah, there's a div now. Okay, just had to put that image in there. Okay, so this is the logo. So I want to put in a logo that's not just that. We're going to have to get out the Photoshop, okay, and get our crop tool. I'm going to crop the Ohio family. That's good. See, right, let's see. Nice. Press enter, and you can do this yourself. Actually, I'll probably put this inside the assets. File, export, save for web. Oops, what's going on? File, export, save for web. For you guys that have an older version of Photoshop, it's just file, save for web, not export. And then I'll save it as a JPEG this time. I do PNGs when it's a see-through. And then let me go to my Ohio Dental images folder. And inside here, I'm going to write logo. So now I have a logo.png and I have a logo.jpg. My logo.jpg, that's what I want to use. Let's go back here and put JPEG. Save that. Let's go back to our and refresh. Ta-da! Now we have a little bit of a line down here. Wonder what that is. So what I'd like to do is I like to put a right off the bat a hreference equals and then index.html. So this logo will be on every page and it will link right back to the home page. Let's save that. And let's go to Chrome and refresh. And now when I hover over it, it looks like this. I can click on it and it goes back to the index page. That's great. Okay. So now let's do some more HTML, CSS. I want to play with some stuff. Where's my CSS? All right. So before header, let me go back to CSS. And we have margin, CSS margin on the left here. What I'm looking to do is, I want to tell you what I'm doing. What I'm doing is, see that little white area right up here over the div? I want to get rid of that margin. So there's a couple of different ways to do that. I could write body, copy this part right here, put that there, and then write margin 0%. And then background color, let's make it blue for now so we can see what's going on. Save that and refresh. There we go. Did you see it went up to the top and the blue is there in the background?